did out on the field today. We used a tripod to get some of those nice tilt-down shots. Hopefully they turn out pretty good in post, but you guys will see that in a little bit. Also, this is my mighty thing because you know what? My hand shakes too much, and these are my babies. Lumix Panasonic G7s. I would strongly recommend it, and let's see what else I can film that's pretty cool.
It's a student-run and directed program here at the university that's assisted by a couple senior faculty members. I am a student worker, so I do directing, camera operating, graphics, replay, you name it, for the broadcast. It's a really fun job, and it's a lot of hands-on activity with the major.
Spider-Man 3 dance.
So that was part one of the documentary, the behind the scenes for the documentary on BUSN. And it was a really cool opportunity to do and be a part of. And I'll let you guys know when the full video is out. But here at Shield of Hope, what we wanted to do a little bit, which I've always wanted to do, was give you some behind the scenes of what I do on other side projects, documentaries, or just little video projects in general with me and my friends. That's kind of what we wanted to do with Shield of Hope. And I mean, we're not going to turn this into a tutorial-based program, but there are some tutorials that we are going to do. And one today, we are going to do the... We're not going to do... There's two different versions that you could do, which what I liked. But the opening shot here is with him running on the ground. We did like sort of an overlay of like a blurred image of his legs like cutting back and forth one way to the other in certain moments in time. And I'll get to showing you how you do that. You can also do the glitch effect, but I will show you that in a different video because we did something with a women's tennis team that I think you guys will enjoy with the glitch effect. So we're going to go right into it. The first thing you got to figure out, especially with whatever clip you're going to use, is what exactly is your intention with the opening shot. I mean, you want a cool shot to open up with. And I thought this low angled shot of the guy doing his drills on the football field was going to work really well. So what I ended up doing was... I actually slowed it down to about 78% of the speed. So it gave the clip a little bit longer because when you do these drills, they're typically faster. So I slowed it down, and at certain points in time, I cut up the clip, little segments. And then after that, I copied the footage, put it above in a different track, kept the same speed. But what I did was I lowered the opacity so you could see the layer, and I actually expanded the scale and the proportion off to the left, to the right, whatever direction I wanted to go. Cut it together, put some music on it, and here's the final result. Now you can also do this, there's two different ways. You can also do this with the glitch effect, which I will show you later. Here's what this looks like. I didn't end up going with this because I actually covered the Bloomsburg women's tennis team. And I use that effect, a lot of that. And you don't really want to repeat things. I don't want to be J.J. Abrams here with the lens flare in every shot. But that tutorial will come out eventually. So there you have it. There's a little bit of insight from the editing room. Why I did that, I think it looks pretty cool, and I think it adds something to the shot. There's a little bit of insight to editing about why I do certain things. There are reasons why editors in the editing room mix it up a little bit. And like, there's certain editors that like to edit with the music. I'm one of those people where I will sit down and I'll edit. And then halfway through the editing, when I don't know what direction I want to take it, then I find the music that I want to and put it in there. There's a lot of free music out there, guys, so go explore, just follow the guidelines, and you'll be good. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully there you saw a little bit of behind the scenes of day one and that you liked it. There's other things that we got coming out, so this is, again, Shield of Hope Productions.